Patty, if we really ask who is the Buddhist, what is the Buddhist, then the, because our parents go to the temple occasionally with Father, so then we call ourselves as a Buddhist. But among the Buddhists, not only among the Buddhists, among the other people, what is the common legacy is the basic understanding about the Buddhism, the foundations of Buddhism. It is also the same. Yoga is very popular, not only in Malaysia, but throughout the whole world. Yoga is very popular. Millions of people are practicing yoga as a part of the physical, their physical design or lifestyle or spiritual practice. They practice yoga. But what if you ask what really yoga is, not many people answer it straight away. So, but then, despite the huge popularity, so not many people are aware of the fact that the essence of yoga is actually not about stretching here and the exercises, not like that. The essence of yoga is about meditation. Why do we meditate? So we can develop our awareness. Awareness is sati. In Pali, the sati, awareness. What is the awareness? Awareness is unique human ability among all other things. And because awareness is something, we always stay in our grasp. Whenever we turn our attention around, to look, our attention always scattered outside. Awareness always stay whenever we turn our awareness to within. For example, we are not aware if I don't mention who is your neighbor sitting right next to you. But if we put our attention awareness there, we right away we are aware of our surroundings. So this awareness something always there, but it's something so subtle that we don't usually aware much by and large. So instead, we open space out and then mindless and function rather mechanically day in, day out. Very mechanical. The word function is very mechanical. So this results, mechanical functioning, mindless way of carrying ourselves, this results in boredom, unhappiness, and troubles, and becomes the various causes of disease and stresses. So to prevent more joyful and spontaneous way of living. In Buddhism, these are expressed as dukkha, which is the first noble truth, dukkha. In yogic terms, in the yoga language, they are called as klesha. Klesha means afflictions. Dukkha means suffering, and klesha means afflictions. Afflictions that which clouds our attention, our awareness, so prevent to shine forward of our original nature, that which is a pure consciousness. Therefore, to explain where we are living as more natural being, fully awakened, we are able to live more naturally and harmonious living, which is the ideal and enlightened way of living. So, the term does yoga mean simply union or bringing together our body, mind, and spirit. So we become more wholesome beings which who can live free from suffering or afflictions. There are many different yogic paths in fact to assist us to teach to the top of the mountain. There are many different mountains. We want the goal of our human life is to reach the top of the mountain, which is enlightenment. And to reach the top of the mountain, there are many different paths to reach, to go. So for example, there are many different yogic paths that express it. So for example, there is a called Bhakti Yoga, which means the yoga of devotions. And there is also Karma Yoga, means the yoga of selfless action or self-transcending actions. The late Mother Teresa, the the late Mother Teresa's part was the typical combination of bhakti and karma yoga combined. She expressed her love of Jesus in the form of serving the poor. Same way, the brothers and sisters in this temple who dedicate their precious time and effort in selflessly in the service of community services, they are also good examples of bhakti or karma yoga combined practices. This is also known as jnana yoga. Jnana means knowledge, which is more suited for more intellectually inclined people. So those religious scholars, they are in this category who pursue the path of jnana yoga. And there is also called Raja Yoga. Raja means king, for the kings and the queens. It doesn't mean that this yoga is for kings and queens, but it is the meditational yogic path that elevates us to be like a king. So then, what's mostly known as yoga in this contemporary world this day is actually Hatha Yoga, that emphasizes on physical discipline by using different various yoga postures and yoga breathings, asanas or pranayama. It is meant to increase the physical flexibility and strength. So in turn, it helps us to improve our health and vitality, so that our body becomes better vehicle to travel to the inner part of our spiritual journey. More than anything, Hatha Yoga is an excellent tool to enhance our awareness. We can't sit still in this room if our body is not well tuned. It's even more impossible to feel easy and comfortable in doing various yoga postures if we can't focus our attention in the body and in the breath during yoga sessions. So the awareness of here and now happens spontaneously while we are trying to balance and perform different postures in the yoga, including with our unstable body and rough breath. So during yoga session, if our awareness is lacking, in no time we slip, we lose our balance. So, as the saying goes, sound body is the sound mind. So if our body is not healthy, not in good shape or conditions, no matter how much weight or fame we have, no matter how smart or intelligent we are, we can't enjoy all the goodness or the happiness that life has to offer. That is why Hatha Yoga is one of the most popular practices, yoga practices throughout the world, because it's easily available to anyone, regardless of their age, or the genders, or the fitness levels. Likewise, there are many other types of yoga religions and spiritual practice as well. And all these different types of yoga do not mean that they are contradicting each other. They are actually complementary each other, like all the parts of a horse, which together constitutes all the mountain. Different way of living, different way of approaching the truth, but they all, the goal is to reach the top of the mountain, which is to attain the freedom, liberation, or spiritual emancipation. So, among all these seemingly different parts